Hello kids, hope you are all fine. Welcome to another lecture for social science. So in the last class we have completed the entire chapter. We are discussing the textual question answers. And for a note of you, that for this third and fourth chapter we'll not be having the worksheet, okay? Even I don't have, and you all people might not also having the worksheet. You all might not be having the worksheet, so it is no issue. In the revision time, as we do, or later on, I will come to know about that worksheet. What and something will be done regarding the worksheet. Okay, so you no need to worry right now about the worksheet. Okay, it will be done as soon as possible, because every parents have not got this worksheet for their children for chapter 3 and 4. It was already made for in the last year, but due to some problems everyone could not get this worksheet. So it's no issue, it's not a big problem. In this revision time, when we'll be doing the revision, that time maybe we'll be discussing the worksheet for chapter 3 and 4. Okay, so you no need to worry about that, and I hope by book A and also book B we had completed all the question answers, and I hope that everybody is understanding and everybody has understood what I have explained, and the chapter is really interesting. It was a really interesting chapters, the previous three chapters. Okay, we had completed three chapters, and I hope that all might have completed the notes or might be completing the notes of chapter 3. Yeah, so I hope please do it well, and beyond that, above that, study really very well, because it is very important. You have to read the textbook, first thing, that is the foremost thing. Secondly, you have to complete the notes of book A as well as book B, all the question answers, and you have to study it properly. For first and second chapter we had the worksheet, right? So you have to learn from the worksheet also of chapter 1 and 2. In 3 and 4, we are not having. Later on we'll be having the worksheet. At that time I'll give you the answers, and you'll be writing down in the notebook first, then you will be learning. Okay, so that will be for later. Worksheet for chapter 3 and 4 will be for later. Okay, so as if now we had completed the entire chapter number 1, 2 and 3, and today's video lecture is and today's section is for for the startup of new chapter, that is chapter number 4. What is the name of the chapter? Soil resources. Yes, I hope that many kids, many children might be knowing regarding what is the soil. Have you seen the soil? Do you have any idea regarding soil? Yeah, the one which we stand upon. Okay, when we look down, when we look down, we might see the sand. Okay, or we might see the soil. It is not at, yeah. So there, not only that, there are many types of soil. Some soil are been utilized in the farming purpose. Okay, and while some soil might be used for the construction purpose, it's like that. It has various kinds of, as we have seen in the last chapter, rocks. It has variety types of rocks, and each one has their own special characters, and they are used by in a other or different ways. In the same way, soil is also something which has many kind, and each of that soil part has different ways of usage. Okay, so I hope that you are understanding. So today's lecture is for chapter number 4, that is soil resources. So to start with, let us clear the title, means we have to understand regarding what actually soil is. What do you mean by the term? What do you mean by that word soil? What is that? So we have to first understand what is soil, then we will move on forward for the types of soil. Okay, so let's understand first what is a soil. So soil is a complex mixture of different components like pebbles, air and water. See, pebbles word is familiar with you, with us, right? Or might be knowing, might be familiar with this word pebbles, as in the last lecture we had seen in the sedimentary rocks. In that portion we have seen, means sedimentary is a kind of mixture of many sediments, and sediments include what? Yeah, pebbles. Pebbles is a kind of a sediment that is included in sedimentary rocks. So pebbles means small stones, small stones, that is known as pebbles. So soil is a complex mixture of what? It is a mixture of different components. Like, which are those components? They are pebbles, air and water. When these three things mix up together, is what means, what is formed with this? Soil, which is known as a soil. That is soil. So I hope that you have understood regarding what is soil. Once again, let's see, what is a soil? Soil is a complex mixture of different components like pebbles, air and water. And what is the second point regarding soil? It is essential for human beings, plants as well as animals. So they are very useful for all of us. We are human beings, right? So it is very essential for all the human beings as well as the plants as well as the for animals in different ways. How we can say that? This could be known by the by knowing the types of soil. That's why this question arises, means how for plants and animals, means that is what the question arises, that some kind of soil is there which is which might be useful for plants also, or which might be useful for human beings as well as which might be useful for animals. That's why they have been diversified in different ways. So there are, in the book you are having six type of soil. Which are they? First is black soil. You can see in your textbook in page number 44 it is given. First is black soil. Second is red soil. Third is alluvial soil. Fourth is laterite soil. Fifth is desert soil. And sixth is mountain soil. So these are the six type or six kinds of soil that we are going to see in this chapter. But for today's lecture, we are going to discuss, or we are going to know about three type of the soil. And then the next lecture, we'll be discussing the other three soil. Okay, so today we are going to discuss the first three type of soil. Which are they? First is black soil, means it is given in page number 44. You can see, first is black soil, second is red soil, and third is alluvial soil. So these are the three kind of soil that we are going to discuss today. As a part, this would be very easier for you to understand. Okay, so as I have some small amount of space in this board, I had written on the other side of the board. So let me change that. Yes, so this is what I had written regarding the soil. Okay, I hope that the end portion is it visible. I think so. It is visible for you all. Yes. I hope that now it is clear for you all. Yes. So this is what the three kind of soil today we are going to discuss. So what is the first one? It is a black soil, as we are going to discuss today. See, this is a type of soil which is black in color. That's why it means the name itself has black soil. So it is a black in color and it is rich in clay. This soil has more amount of clay present in it. Okay. And what is the second point regarding that? It is also called what? Black lava soil. So in your textbook it is given. You can look down in your textbook also. While I explain, you have to look down into your textbook and you have to underline this point. What is that? It is also, or black soil is also called black lava soil. So that black lava soil is given in bold letters in your textbook. So that you have to underline. So it is also called black lava soil. Why? Why it is known as black lava soil? Because as it is formed from the lava rocks. Lava is what, as we have seen in the previous chapters, lava is a thing that comes out of volcano. It is made up of hot molten magma. Okay, so this soil is formed from the lava rocks. So which is why this black soil is also known as black lava soil. Okay, understood? Okay, what is the third point regarding black soil? See, it is fertile and found in Deccan Plateau. See, fertile in the sense means, what do you mean by the term? Fertile means this could be used for agriculture purpose or for the farming purpose, this soil could be used. So it is fertile and it is found in the Deccan Plateau regions. Means which are those regions? It is found in the regions such as Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat. Okay, so these are kind of 2-3 places where this black soil is found, or the regions. So that also you have to underline. Means black soil is found in the Deccan Plateau regions of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh as well as Gujarat. So these are the few points that you can see. Now, what is the next point? It is best suited for cultivation of cotton. So for the cultivation, means as I have said, for the farming or the cultivation, for cultivating, this soil is used for the cultivation of cotton, for sugarcane cultivation, for wheat cultivation, as well as oil seeds cultivation. So this is kind of the uses for this black soil is what it is used as, or suited for the cultivation of cotton, for sugarcane, for wheat, as well as for oil seeds. So this is what black soil is all about. So next thing you have to do is here in your textbook it is a few more cultivation part is also given. Which are they? Wheat cultivation, oil seeds, millets, as well as tobacco. So I have written just up to this, but a few more are given in your textbook, as I was not having that space. But you can look in your textbook. They are used for cultivation of what? Cotton, sugarcane, wheat, and then oil seeds, as well as millets and tobacco. The cultivation of millets and tobacco is also done with this black soil. So this is what the points, entire point regarding this black soil is. Now what is the second kind of soil that we are going to discuss today? That is red soil. The second soil that we are going to discuss is red soil. Now let's understand what is this red soil. See, in your textbook you can look down the picture. See, it is kind of red colored soil. Okay, in your picture, left of that explanation part. Now let's understand what this red soil is about. See, it is not very fertile, means this soil cannot be used for cultivation purpose. Not fertile means it cannot be used for cultivation purpose, but it is rich in iron. This soil has iron content in it. Iron is present in this soil. And second point is, it is found in states of which kind of states? In which kind of states this red soil you can find? in the states of Tamil Nadu, in Karnataka, as well as in Madhya Pradesh. So in these three kind of states, you can mostly find this red soil. Okay, now what is the third point regarding this red soil? It is the best suited for agricultural crops like potatoes. Okay, so it is most suited for which kind of cultivation? For the cultivation of potatoes. It is not for the cultivation, for agriculture purpose. Yeah, because cultivation means it would be for, then it would be fertile, but this is not for cultivation. This is for the suited for the agricultural crops. Like, which are the agricultural crops? Means, like, as we can say, potatoes. For the agriculturing of potatoes, for groundnuts, for millets, for ragi. In your textbook you can see, for tobacco, for wheat, as well as for maize. So for this kind of agricultural purpose, this red soil is been used. Now what is the third soil that we are going to discuss in page number 44? The third one is, it is fertile. Yeah, obviously this soil is fertile, and it is mainly found in the coastal plains. Okay, on the coastal areas this kind of alluvial soil is found, and the silt and sand together form the alluvial soil. Now what is that silt? Okay, means the rivers. Okay, the rivers that flow from the Himalayan mountains, what do they do? Okay, they bring a large deposits of silt and sand. It is kind of a thing which is found, you can see on the seashore when you go, you can see a silt. Okay, it is small kind of tiny thing. Okay, you can see down in the picture over the right, you can see look at the picture of alluvial soil. See, kind of see white colored some dot type is there. Okay, so this is what known as silt. Okay, so that silt and sand together form the alluvial. So when these both of this thing get together, it forms the alluvial soil. Now what is the third point? It is found in the UP, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Punjab, Haryana and Gujarat. So in these kind of states, this alluvial soil is found. Now what is the fourth point? Cultivation of crops like, now what kind of cultivation could be made from this soil? The cultivation of crops like rice, maize, wheat, tobacco, pulses, groundnut, as well as for vegetables. For the cultivation of vegetable also, these alluvial soil is necessary, or it is found. So these are the three kind of soil that we have discussed today. Once again, I will repeat. So what is the soil? As we have seen, it is a complex mixture. It is a complex mixture of different kind of components. Which are the three components of soil? They are air, water and pebbles. When these three of the components mix up together, it forms a soil. Okay, so this soil is really available, or it is essential for human beings, animals, as well as for plants. So hence it is, in the coming lecture we'll be coming to know regarding how the soil can be conserved, as they are used for human beings, plants or animals. This soil is very much essential for that, and for making it essential, it is very necessary for the conservation of the soil. As in the last lecture we have seen the conservation of coal and petroleum, how they can be saved or how they can be conserved. In the same way, coal is also could be conserved. So that we'll be knowing in the coming lecture. In the coming lecture we'll be getting into the that topic, which is soil conservation. Okay, so that is what the meaning of soil is. I hope you understood. And today we have seen there are six kind of soils. There are black soil, red soil, alluvial soil, laterite soil, desert soil, as well as mountain soil. And today we have discussed, among that six soil, we have discussed the three soil. Which are they? First is black soil, second is red soil, and third is alluvial soil. So I hope that you have understood.